You can meet me on an airplane or in the back of the bus. You can throw me like a boomerang. I'll come back and beat you up.
For YouTube channel, I'm Angelique. This is my makeup channel. So for today's look, I wanted to do all hair, get it together, my hair. Been in my face all day, I don't know what's going on. I wanted to film this red copper smokey eye silver gold glitter, because I promised you guys I would film some more makeup tutorials using glitter. I had so much fun doing this look. I love this look. I know I do a lot of red smokey eyes all the time, but you know what, I don't care. If somebody says to me, oh, you always do that, can we do something different? Well, you know what I'm going to tell that person? Screw off, watch something else. You don't have to watch my channel if you don't like it. So I just wanted to do what I wanted, and I love this look. It's definitely different than I ever done before, but I love doing red smokey eyes because they bring out my natural color, and they look really good with my skin, especially the skin tone I am at right now, which I am pale AF. But seriously, I'm pretty pale, so like, look, blending with the wall, literally. I had so much fun filming this tutorial. I did film like applying glasses because I know some of you like complain that I don't, I kind of cut out applying glasses, but I kind of show you guys how I do it. I think I'm gonna do that from now on and not cut it out so much. I just like do it to save time and like, you know, because my videos are like, they're not short videos. So I just do it to save time, but a lot of you guys enjoy when I apply the lashes and show you. So I think I'm gonna do that from now on. But this look was pretty easy. I didn't use too many shadows. It's super simple. Love it. I love the smokiness. I did more of a darker outer corner just because I really wanted to make that eye pop. And I love this lip combination. It's one of my favorite lip combinations. I haven't mixed this lip combo on camera before, so I'm really happy I showed you guys, and I love it. Another with the gold team. Here we go. I sent a selfie to my boyfriend, he's gonna be quite J-Lo, but I told him, yeah, I'm like a pale J-Lo, so he called me K-O-O. So it's like an inside joke. I was like, oh yeah, I'm K-O-O. So if you guys want to call me that, you guys can call me that, but whatever. Anyways, you guys, I had so much fun. I mentioned in this video that I know a lot of you guys like this gold liner that I use from Urban Decay. They do have other colors. I have a silver one. So I was thinking of doing a silver halo smoky eye incorporating silver glitter for tomorrow's look. So yeah, and I've never done a halo on this channel yet, and I haven't done silver, which silver is actually one of my favorite colors to do for makeup. It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of festive. A lot of people find it's hard to work with, but it's actually not that hard. So I thought I would incorporate that, and I thought it would be really, really fun for you guys to see. So I'm excited for that tutorial tomorrow. Maybe I'll film a little bit early because of this quarantine. I've been like having a hard time sleeping. I'm gonna be real. I've been watching 48 hours, like, nonstop, and now I get nightmares and I can't sleep. So I'll probably go to bed early, you know, catch up some sleep, because my boyfriend was like, when your routine goes back, like, he stays up all the time because he works at home and he's working on the computer. It doesn't really matter for him. But he says, oh, once I go back to work, it's going to be really hard for me to get back into my routine. But I told him, I just love sleeping in. So I'll go to bed at, like, 2, 3, and I'll wake up at 10:30, and I can't go back to sleep. I don't know what it is. Who knows? But I'm gonna try to go to bed early. I'm gonna try to edit this video before I go to bed. If I don't, I promise I'll post it tomorrow and put all the description box and everything. I had so much fun filming this look for you guys. If you guys like a red copper smoky eye, keep on watching. I love you guys so much, and don't forget to click subscribe. Bye. Boom. Hey, you guys. So we're gonna do my red copper smoky eye with gold glitter. I'm super excited for this look. This is always like my go-to look if I don't know what to do. And it's an amazing look because it looks good on everyone. So I'm super excited. But we're going to contour first. What's new? Where is my contour brush? Oh my god. Where's my contour brush, you guys? Oh my god. Here. Girl, I love this brush. This is the Morphe 530. I'm just going to go in with the very dirty Kat Von D Shade and Light palette. And we're just going to use these two contour shades. So we're just going to dip and contour away, bitches. It's like around 6 o'clock right now. I waited later in the day to film just because it's so hot. I went to do some errands, pick up my prescription in the night. It's literally like about a 10-minute walk. And it's up on a hill where I have to go to the pharmacy. And it was so hot. And I had such a big headache, I fell asleep on the couch, took a little nap, because I was like, I'm really tired, I don't feel like filming right now. And it was just like, I was so hot and maybe dehydrated a little bit and tired. So I just waited like a couple hours or so. Oops, on my lip. Just because like, I don't want to film while I'm sweating my ass off in my apartment. Just saying that it's like crazy hot right now and I'm wearing a sweater. Now we're going to use a bronzer. I want to use a different bronzer today just because I feel like it. I'm going to use, this is the Makeup Forever Professional Paris Pro Bronze Fusion in the shade 25i. It's a really like pretty bronze. It's more like a gel-like consistency. It's not overly powdery and it is waterproof, so it's really nice like if you're out in the sun or you're on vacation, this is a good bronzer to use. And this is not the matte one, this is 25i, so that means it's the iridescent one. And they have one in my shade, but it's 20m, but they're sold out. But this is 25i. It's a really pretty bronzer. I think I've used this before on my channel, and I love Makeup Forever bronzers. They're really pretty. Yeah, it's not too dark. It's a really light wash of bronze. But if you guys notice, like, I never like to use, like, too dark of a bronzer because I think it looks funny. I like a very neutral kind of bronzer. And I don't like anything too red. So I don't think it's flattering on lighter skin tones. But if that's your journey, then do what you want. But this is what I do. And I'm just going to apply some on the forehead. There. Perfect. I like that this powder's not overly cakey, but it is dry, so that's why I don't use it for under my eyes. Okay. Now, we're just going to go in with the Jaclyn Hill palette, of course. This is my favorite palette, and I think I want to use this, what is this shade? It's called Creamsicle. It's this really pretty yellow color. I live. Okay. I'm just going to use this brush. This is the Morphe R37 from the Rose Gold collection. I love this brush. It's so big and fluffy, and it's going to distribute that yellow color really beautifully. So we're just going to dip. I don't have pan, but whatever. We're just going to apply this really softly all over the crease of the lid. And the reason why we're using this yellow shade, because we're going to add more like orangey brick kind of red copper shades. And we basically want this to be like the starting color because it's going to look very like ombre and just reach the top when we add that darker red color after. I'll show you. Okay, now we're going to bake. I'm going to use, oh, my neck hurts. I'm going to use this Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Setting Powder in the shade Lavender. Guys, know I love this powder. I love it because it has a really nice brightening effect. So if you're pale as me, do it. But if you're a darker skin tone, like a more olive skin tone or like a darker one, you can use like a banana powder that complements like darker skin tones. But this is the one I use. I think like Kim Kardashian, she's like the first one to use that Benai banana powder. Like when I was tanned, I religiously used that banana powder. Like I was like on that shit. And then when you apply it, when you have a darker skin tone, or if you were tan like me, it just like made the under eye look really beautiful. This has the same effect, but it's lavender, but I'm just more pale, you know? So once you run out with a good powder, you're screwed. And I don't want to be that girl. I'm just saying. Okay. Perfect. Okay, we're just going to go back in with that creamsicle color. We're just going to extend. Ooh, I hit myself in the boobie. Oh my God, what's happening with me today? There's something going on. We're just going to use that creamsicle color, and using the same R37 brush, we're just going to extend and perfect that first initial shade we went in with. Just basically put it all in the crease. You guys can see. I'm not gonna worry too much about getting it too high on the brow bone. We can just clean it up with concealer later. Different brush today. Hold on. This one. This is the Morphe M573. I think I used this in my glitter fire smoky eye, and I love this brush. It's really soft and fluffy, and it kind of has like a dome shape, so you can get like really into the crease, and it basically like it applies the shadow all over the lid and distributes color in the crease really pretty. And then I'm gonna use this shade. This is like kind of like a brick red color. It's not too red, but it's like a soft, subtle red. And this shade is called Roxanne. And I'm just going to use that color. Then we're going to go in with a darker red. Okay. It's a really pretty color. It's like the perfect kind of brick color. Okay, we're just going to dip and then just apply this all over. Like that. See, it just like applies the color. This is the perfect brush because it applies the shadow all over the lid and the crease at the same time. You know what I mean? Like it's, I love it. And it's so soft. This is like one of my most favorite brushes Morphe's ever made. And just in here. Just gets like really into the socket, into the crease. That's all. Okay, since we apply that color, I'm just gonna go in with the R37. We're not gonna, what's the word? I can't even think right now. We're just gonna use this with no extra shadow with this brush. We're just gonna use what we have on the brush already. We're just gonna blend that red color out. Before I go on to any other colors, I always make sure like all my eyeshadows are blended basically. And if it's like really blotchy, we can go back in and like go back in with that creamsicle color. But for now, I just like mainly want to blend out the harsh lines. I don't need to apply more of that creamsicle color because then I'll be like too yellow. You know what I mean? I don't want to be too yellow. Okay, now we're going to go in with this red color. What is this called? This is called Jax. Yeah, this is really pretty red. It's a little too red. I think I'm going to mix it with, what's this color called? Chip. This is like a chocolatey brown. Yeah, I'm going to mix these two together. That Jax color is a little too red, and I want it more like a chocolatey red. You know what I mean. Okay, just going to use the M433. I love this brush. It's so soft. Okay. See, I want like a dark kind of chocolate red. I'm just going to like pat that into the crease. This. Yeah. When I have like a big palette in front of me, I love mixing colors. I can't just use like one shadow. And I want like a darker red everywhere. Okay. And then we're just gonna use that M573 with that Roxanne color. We're just gonna use this just to blend the crease area basically. Okay, I'm just going to grab more of that Roxanne color because it's not blending like I want it to. So just like softly get up in that crease area. And dip in that creamsicle color. Just like just on the very outer top. Yeah, these colors like blend so well together, you guys. Okay. Okay, now we're going to grab the 242 from MAC, just this a flat guy. I love using this to apply all my glitters. And we're going to use this color called Firework. It's really pretty. Bitch, stay. My palette, like, keeps falling over. I don't know why. Yeah, Firework. This is a really pretty copper color. We're just going to spray. And just apply this everywhere. Like that, yeah. Ooh, yeah, bitch. Yes! And then do the other eye. Okay, now it's just looking choppy at the end there. So I'm just going to go back in with my M433 brush and go in with that Jax and that Chip color. I always do this. So, because I just want that glitter and a matte color to blend really well together. I want to be like super smoky. Okay, then we're going to go back in with the MAC 242 and just basically blend that Firework better. I always do this. I always go back and forth because I want my eye look to be perfect. You know what I mean? Just lightly tap Ooh, yeah. Ooh. This palette is so annoying. Like, it won't stay. Like, stay! Okay, we're just gonna tap that into the brush. We're just gonna apply this color all over. The lower lash line. Just to connect the top area. Okay, just to blend that out, I'm just going to use this Kylie brush. I'm going to go in with that creamsicle color because I want this more blown out before we apply any darker shadows underneath our eye. I always do this because I'm, for a red smoky, I love a blown out lower lash line. I think it just like brings the look together really beautifully. And just apply it like this. Sorry, my mouth is open, you guys. So hard to like close your mouth when you're applying anything on the lower lash line. Yeah, that's good. You want it really like blended and okay. Now I'm just gonna grab, this is a definer brush, this is the M423. We're just gonna grab that Jax color and that Chip color mixed together because that's what we did on the top lid. And then we're going to use this skinny guy. This is the M443. And then we're just going to go in with this MAC Pro Longwear Fluid Line Gel Eyeliner in Black Track. I'm just going to put this in my waterline really quickly. Sorry guys, it's hard to see in the camera. Like that, yeah. I want to do a black liner today because I want it to look smoky. And I want to use the gel liner first because when we blend out that darker red, it's just going to smoke it out a little bit. It's going to be really pretty. Okay, I'm going to go in with the Morphe R41. I'm just going to go in with that Roxanne color again just to blend any harshness. I love this brush. It's so cute and pretty. Eyes are starting to water. I don't know why. Okay. And then we're going to use that Kylie brush again and go in with creamsicle because I want it more blown out than this. Just to make sure it has that smokiness. There we go. Oh yeah, I'm living for this look, you guys. I'm just gonna quickly apply concealer on my eyebrows, and I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape in light. We can perfect my eyebrows. Okay. Okay, perfect. And while that concealer is still wet, I'm just going to apply some In Light and Beam for the brow highlight. Okay, what brush do I want to use? I think I'm going to use, this is the Morphe 213. I'm just going to dip in those two shades. Just highlight the brow bone. Like that. Oh yeah. Love that highlight. Okay, now we're gonna do the inner corner. I'm gonna use a different brush today. I'm gonna use the Morphe 455. This is like perfect because it's really like narrow for the inner corner. So I'm just gonna use that Beam and In Light color. The inner corner, I'm gonna spray. And then we're going to go in with the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette, the Armand Gorgeous palette. I'm just going to do a touch of that VIP shade. I've been loving doing this lately. Like, this eyeshadow is so white, and it just adds, like, that extra pop. You know? Oh, my God. Bitch. Okay. Okay, I'm into it. I'm into it. Loving this eye look, you guys. Forever. Bronzer. I love using bronzer as my nose contour because it's not too harsh. I find if I use a contour powder, it's a little too harsh. And I have a really high bridge on my nose already, and I don't want to make it too harsh. Okay, and then we're just gonna use this Morphe Y11 from the Gold Collection. We're just gonna go in with the Kat Von D Shade and Light Palette using these two highlighting shades just because it's looking very dull under my eye from that translucent powder. I wanna add some life back. Just like. I'm sure it looks crazy, but whatever. Who cares? Okay, we're just going to apply some mascara. This is the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise. Okay. Oh my God, I just poked myself in the eye with the wand. Oh, I was watering there a little bit. Ugh. There we go. Okay, I'm going to apply lashes, and I'm actually going to do that on camera because a lot of people have been asking me, why don't you apply the lashes, like, on camera? So, since yesterday I messed up on my makeup, I just applied it on camera because I don't want to, like, stop and then film and then stop. Yeah, so I'm just going to do it on camera. And then if it's too long, I'll just cut that part out of the video. Yeah, a lot of people were asking me, how come you don't, like, apply lashes on camera? I was like, I don't know. I make ugly faces. But we're just going to use the Intoxicating Lashes because these are my favorite. And these are the Double Lift. So they actually have two layers on them. That's why they're so beautiful. Oh, my God. I have glue on the end here. Okay, and then I'm just going to use this duo glue. This is my favorite glue. I can buy this from London Drugs. You can get it at MAC, Sephora, whatever places. I love duo because you can buy it at the drugstore. So if you're on set or, like, you're doing a photo shoot and you don't have, like lash glue, you just go to the drugstore, go get it, get me some duo, bitches. Skin's like, it's still too wet, so I want it to be really tacky, so that's why I wait 60 seconds And then we're just going to use the tweezers and just apply them. And then I basically just wiggle around the tweezers and place them really close to the lash line. Ta-da! It's that easy. And then I'll use the tweezers to stamp my real lash with the false lash, just so they look together. I don't curl my lashes anymore, just because you don't want your real lashes too curled, and then you can't actually apply the false lashes. But if you got, when I use new lashes, like say this is a new package, I use new lashes. After I apply the false lashes, I'll use an eyelash curl to make them like curl together. But after that, I don't do that because you don't want it too curled. Then you look scary. You want it to have like a natural curl. I used to do that all the time and I was like, why is my lash not? If you guys are doing that, that's probably why your lashes aren't applying like how you want it to. So ask yourself that. Okay, this one's kind of like, okay, and then we're just gonna apply the other one and just, I usually like look straight and pop it right on, like that, and then you just wanna like perfect the corners. With the tweezers. Ta-da! Done. This is why, like, I don't understand how people tell me all the time that they don't know how to apply the lash. It's, like, literally the easiest thing ever. And I've been doing makeup since as in elementary school, grade 6. So it's taken me, like, over 10 years to do it. I would say, like, 15 years. But practice makes perfect, and see, that's a perfect lash. It's so like smoky and beautiful. I love it. Okay. Yeah, I'm living for this tutorial. Okay, we're gonna move on to glitter because I want to, and if I don't do it now, I'll forget because I'm that forgetful. Okay, we're going to go in with the Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter Eyeliner. This is in the shade Midnight Cowboy. I'll swatch it for you guys. It's such a pretty color. And I just want to apply this under my lashes. Like, it's so pretty. This is definitely one of their top selling products because I went to look it up online. So I think I used it in a different video. I think I did it in my cut crease video and I went to Sephora. It was sold out and I was like, bitch. Yeah, I think I bought this in store because usually I don't have it online because it's a pretty popular color. Okay. And I like you can go in and kind of swirl it. You don't want too thick. We're just going to apply this underneath the lashes. Like that. Yeah. It's really pretty. Oh my god, that's so pretty. Okay, we're going to do the other lash. Make sure it's not too thick because you don't want to like it to be goopy and then apply it. You want a really thin kind of area. Rest of the face. Just going to use this Jeffree Star brush. This is the Morphe Times Jeffree Star JS1. Hi there. how the hell are ya? I think that's how he does it. Oh, whatever. Or just gonna remove that. I love this brush. It's really soft. Oh my god. I just got glitter on my eye here. Okay, it's okay. I grabbed a spoolie and took it off. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm telling you guys, I generally use this brush I had the Kat Von D powder on and just like rub it away. I tell you, I'm like, okay, don't like look up and look down because I have a sparkle here. See, you guys, I'm such a perfectionist. Yeah, because when I was like removing the powder, I was like looking. Yeah, don't do that. Just like look straight in the mirror. I think that's what I did. So just look straight in the mirror. Don't look up. Don't look down because the glitter's still wet right now. So you just want to like make sure that it's not everywhere. I think I know why I do this last. But I wanted to dry it before I applied mascara, but whatever. Now I'm just going to grab that gold brush from Morphe, the Y11. And then just because it's looking a little dull and flat under my face, I'm just going to use those two highlighting shades. I just want to give my face some life. Okay. I'm just gonna go back because there's like no bronzer there. The bronzer kind of like went away when we removed that translucent setting powder. So I'm just gonna go back in with that Makeup Forever bronzer. We're just gonna darken the cheekbones a little bit. Kylie blush today. So this is the Kylie Cosmetics. I can't even open it. Okay, so this is the Kylie Press blush powder in the shade Kitten Baby. I love this blush just because it's like a really pretty apricot. I'll swatch it for you. And I love her blushes. Like this one's such a pretty color. And I think it'll be really pretty with this warm, coppery, smoky eye. Okay, I'm just going to use the Kylie brush just because. Kylie together, Kylie, whatever. Yeah. Ooh. I love her blushes. They're so, so creamy. Okay, we're just looking in the camera because we don't want to look up or down or I'll ruin that glitter. I'm sure it's dry by now. Okay, just lightly. Yeah, there. Girl, yes! Okay. I know that's like a lot of blush right now, but don't worry, we're going to highlight. We're just going to go in with the Ambient Lighting Powder in Luminous Light. This is my favorite, and we're going to use the Morphe M500. I love this brush. I'm just going to like kind of diffuse the blush and kind of add this like really pretty glow before we add actual highlight. Yeah. Okay, that's really, really pretty. Into that, and then before we apply actual highlight, I'm just going to use the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. You guys know I love this setting mist. Okay, I'm just going to spray. I'm going to use this one. So this is the Makeup Forever. What is this? This is the Pro Light Fusion Undetectable Luminizer in the shade 02. It's a really pretty gold. Like, this is one of my go-to highlights. I love it. Okay, and then I'm just going to use... Hi, how are ya? Jeffree Star Morphe Highlight Brush JS4. I love this brush because it's so like dome-like and fluffy, and it's my go-to recently. I'm just gonna lightly apply this to the skin. And I want a really gold highlight with this copper look. I haven't done a smoky eye in a while, so I'm into this clean tip side part. I'm just gonna like dab in the sponge. And what is, go away here. And we're just gonna press this onto the cheeks for like a really seamless glow. I've been loving doing this method recently. So it just like makes it look really like glass-like and dewy. I'm into it. Just lightly. Yes. I win. Okay. Just because it's a little too gold, I think I'm going to use a Becca highlight in Champagne Pop. So this is a really pretty highlight because it has a lot of peachy kind of undertones. And I don't want it to be too gold. I'm just going to go back in with the Jeffree Star highlighting brush. This is the JS4 on the clean side. Just like lightly tap and just like basically apply just on the top of the cheeks. Oh my god. Bitch. Yes. I don't know what's wrong. Like, why is my lip so dry? Okay. Whatever. Okay. I think I want to do like a really nude lip. I'm just going to use this lip liner. This is the Huda Beauty Lip Contour in Wifey. I love this lip liner just because it's such a really pretty light pinky nude. Which, on camera before, but it's one of my favorite nudes actually. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills liquid lipstick in the shade Naked. It's a really kind of like peachy nude. I'll swatch it for you guys. It's really pretty, and I think it'll be really pretty. It has like a warm undertone, so it'll be super pretty with this eye look. I'm gonna use this one because it has like a really kind of rosy, peachy, gloss kind of look, and it has some shimmer in it, I think. No, it doesn't, but it's a really nice color. But this is the NARS lip gloss in Chelsea Girls. This is one of my favorite lip glosses. I'll swatch it for you. And it's so pretty with this liquid lip. I've used it before, but not on camera. Okay. I just don't like the packaging because it's really hard to get out of the tube. It's similar to the NARS Creamy Concealer, which I don't like that concealer, and the packaging is awful, but whatever. I'm just going to work with it. Whoa! Okay, I'm just going to use, this is the Morphe Continuous Setting Spray. We're just going to seal the deal before we apply the rest of the face. Okay, I'm just going to apply some brow gel really quickly. Okay, now for bottom lash mascara. So I'm pretty sure that glitter has dried, so that's why I apply the glitter before we apply the mascara. Because when you look down, I don't want it to touch any other part of my skin. Okay, we're just going to go in with the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. Such a long name for a mascara, but okay. Oh, bitch. Yes. I'm just going to curl my hair real quick. I'll be right back. Thank you guys for this channel. Yeah, so this my red copper smoky eye incorporated with glitter. I actually love this look. I do this look on a daily basis just because it's like, if you ever want to do a smoky eye and just add a little oomph, just add some glitter on the bottom lashes. You can even do this with like a silver, but I would do more of like a silver eye, not so much like a red eye. Like, I find red smoky eyes go really well with gold. That's why I did more of a gold highlight, which I thought was a bomb. I love this nude lip color. Like, it's kind of like a pinky nude, and it's really pretty with this eye look. It's like super warm and smoky. This lip color is super warm and smoky. It's about 9 o'clock right now. I did film a little bit later in the day because I felt really tired and I wasn't feeling good. I think I like had a heat stroke because like I was doing really awesome earlier and I didn't really want to film earlier. So there's no lighting in my apartment, but I turned on the light in my kitchen, so I had to take some selfies there. And it felt like one of my girlfriends told me to use the fridge light, but I was trying. It doesn't work for me. I don't know, maybe my fridge is like just a shitty fridge, but it's a pretty new fridge though. But I know Nikita Dragon, she uses her fridge light. Like, I mean, it's bomb, but I just can't get the angle right. I think because I've never done it before, but oh well. Anyways, you guys, I had so much fun filming this video. I think tomorrow I want to film like a hollow silver smoky eye incorporating silver glitter, because I've never done silver on my channel, and I know a lot of you guys do like this Urban Decay liner glitter. You guys love that I use it on my channel, so I thought I would just use silver, and I've never done silver on my channel, and I think that'll be a lot of fun. And I don't do a lot of halo smoky eyes. They're like really good. They're really good, like, if you have small eyes, and a lot of people don't know how to do the technique, but the way I do it, maybe my technique is gonna have a bomb-ass halo glitter smoky eye. I tell you, yeah, you just need to, like, work with your eyes and kind of play with them, because I have small eyes, it's kind of hard, but I've been perfecting my halo smoky eyes for a few years now, and I'm into it, and this look I'm gonna do tomorrow, I've been doing it for a while, and people love it. I think I want to do like a more nude lip. This is a sneaky eye. Yeah, I think so. I'm into it. And I'm always wanting to do different things on my YouTube here. So I don't want to do the same thing every time. I just felt like I needed to do this look. I live for it. Love the gold highlights. Yeah. I'm going to do that. I'm actually going to go to bed earlier. Having a really hard time going to bed early because it's quarantine. I'll go to bed at like 3 or 2 and then wake up at 2:30, and then I'm just tired throughout the day. But I'm gonna go to bed early, have a shower. I'm gonna try to finish editing this video tonight. Not, I'll wake up really early tomorrow to do it, but I'll definitely post it tomorrow. Anyways, you guys, I can't wait to see you tomorrow. I filmed a silver halo glitter smoky eye, but that's it for this channel. I hope you guys enjoy this look. If you guys do this look, please hit the button and don't forget to subscribe. I love you guys so much. Bye.